Many women are becoming pregnant later in life. Providers use the term advanced maternal age to describe a pregnancy in a person greater than 35 years old. If this term applies to you, I'd like to reassure you that with good prenatal care, you can have a completely normal, healthy pregnancy and delivery. It does mean that the risks for certain complications during pregnancy are slightly increased, and it's important to know what you can do to help minimize those risks. Becoming pregnant can be more difficult after age 35, and once you are pregnant, there is an increased risk of ectopic pregnancy, miscarriage, and chromosomal abnormalities for the fetus. Some studies have shown that a miscarriage loss rate can be as high as 40% for women over age 35, and this increases to greater than 60% for women older than age 40. This information may be helpful to you as you consider when you want to share the news that you are pregnant with others, and also if you do experience a loss, to know it is not your fault. The risk of the pregnancy having abnormal chromosomes, such as Down syndrome, is increased after age 35. For example, at age 20, the risk of your fetus having Down syndrome is about 1 in 1,500. But at age 35, the risk of your fetus having Down syndrome is about 1 in 350. You will be offered genetic screening and diagnostic tests to help identify abnormal chromosomes if you desire. For a more detailed explanation of the options you will have for fetal chromosome testing, please see our Motherhood TV video on this topic. Pregnancy can be thought of as a stress test on your body. As we age, the chances of high blood pressure and diabetes go up in general, and when we are pregnant, this might manifest clinically for the first time. As your pregnancy progresses, you are at higher risk for hypertensive diseases and pre-eclampsia, increased risk of gestational diabetes, and a slightly increased risk of stillbirth when compared with younger women. High blood pressure during pregnancy for a woman who has never previously had high blood pressure is called gestational hypertension. If the high blood pressure impacts other organs, such as the kidneys, then the diagnosis might be pre-eclampsia. If the blood pressure or end organ impact is severe, preterm delivery may be necessary for your health. Consistent prenatal care can help protect women who develop these conditions by catching these conditions early, and home blood pressure monitoring is often helpful. Antenatal testing during the pregnancy and sometimes induction of labor before your due date may be recommended. All women greater than 35 years old should be tested for gestational diabetes between 24 and 28 weeks of pregnancy. The placenta secretes a hormone that increases the chances of diabetes in an effort to ensure sufficient food for the fetus. In older women or women with other risk factors, this can actually lead to a dangerous excess of glucose or sugar in the bloodstream, impacting both the fetal and the maternal health. Again, consistent prenatal care and management can help minimize these effects. Sometimes medication may be recommended, and home blood glucose monitoring is often helpful. Antenatal testing during the pregnancy and often induction of labor before the due date may be recommended. There is a small but increased risk of stillbirth, especially for pregnant patients greater than 40 years old. A woman who is pregnant for the first time after age 40 has an approximately 1 in 116 risk of stillbirth. Depending on your exact age and risk factors, your provider may recommend antenatal testing and possibly an early induction of labor between 39 and 40 weeks of gestation. One of the most important things you can do to ensure a healthy pregnancy is to seek early prenatal care. If possible, schedule a preconception appointment with your primary care provider to discuss your current medications, health status, and if any vaccines or genetic screening may be helpful. Risk factors compound on each other, so the healthier your starting weight and your baseline health is when you become pregnant, the more likely you are to have a smooth pregnancy. Discuss with your provider if you qualify to start a low-dose course of oral aspirin during your pregnancy. This is especially important if you have any other risk factors, such as this is your first baby, you have a BMI of greater than 30, a family history of preeclampsia, especially in your mother or your sister, or a history of high blood pressure or diabetes, autoimmune or renal disease, a twin pregnancy, a triplet pregnancy, or other sociodemographic factors. As always, aim to start a prenatal vitamin with folic acid at least 1 to 3 months before trying to become pregnant, and initiate a health routine for foods and exercise. Regardless of your age, we here at UC San Diego Health are here to support you for a happy, healthy, and enjoyable pregnancy.